On 15th August 2019, Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched its flagship program, the Jal Jeevan Mission. The goal of the scheme is to provide assured tap water to all rural households in a time-bound mission mode by 2024. This presentation by India Water Portal provides the broad overview of the scheme, its objective, action plan, funding, and lot more. With the growing population and expanding economic activities in the country, there is an increase in demand for water. With finite availability of water and competing demands, drinking water management has become a complex issue. The widening demand-supply gap is further compounded by other challenges like groundwater depletion due to over-extraction, poor recharge, low storage capacity, erratic rainfall, presence of contaminants, poor operation and maintenance of water supply systems, etc. These challenges have put further pressure on the rural population, which have catered to their water needs using traditional knowledge and their water wisdom. Therefore, there is a need to provide piped water supply to the rural population for improving the health and socio-economic condition of local communities and to also bring down the drudgery of rural women and girls. As per the Integrated Management Information System maintained by the Department of Drinking Water and Sanitation, as on 31st March 2019, only 18% of the total 17.87 crore rural households in the country have tap water connections. Thus, about 14.6 crore households are without tap water connection and are planned to be covered in partnership with states, union territories under the Jal Jeevan Mission by 2024. The broad objectives of the mission are to provide and monitor functional household tap water connection to every rural household, schools, Anganwadi centers, health centers, wellness centers, and community buildings. To prioritize provision of FHTCs in quality affected areas, villages in drought prone and desert areas, Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana villages, etc. To promote and ensure voluntary ownership among local community by way of contribution in cash, kind and voluntary labor. To assist in ensuring sustainability of water supply system, that is the water sources, water supply infrastructure and funds for regular operation and maintenance. To empower and develop human resources in the sector such that the demands of construction, plumbing, water quality management, water treatment, catchment protection, etc. are taken care of in short and long term, and to bring awareness on various aspects and significance of safe drinking water and an involvement of stakeholders in a manner that make water everyone's business. Jal Jeevan Mission has 8 components. Number 1. Development of in-village piped water supply infrastructure to provide tap water connection to every rural household. Number 2. Development of reliable drinking water sources and/or augmentation of existing sources to provide long-term sustainability of water supply system. Number 3. Wherever necessary, bulk water transfer, treatment plants and distribution network to cater to every rural household. Number 4. Technological interventions for removal of contaminants where water quality is an issue. Number 5. Retrofitting of completed and ongoing schemes to provide FHTCs at minimum service level of 55 LPCD. Number 6. Grey water management. Number 7. Support activities like Information Education and Communication IEC, Human Resources Development, Training, Development of Utilities, Water Quality Laboratories, Water Quality Testing and Surveillance, Research and Development, Knowledge Center, Capacity Building of Communities, etc. Number 8, any other unforeseen challenges or issues emerging due to natural disasters or calamities which affect the goal of FHTC to every household by 2024 as per the guidelines of Ministry of Finance on Flexi Funds. Community-led partnership with the states and union territories will be the strategy for achieving the objectives of Jal Jeevan Mission. Communities can therefore make the best of this opportunity and ensure that every rural household has FHTC of prescribed quality on a regular basis as may be decided by the Gram Panchayat or its subcommittee. State government and its departments are to play the role of facilitator. The government believes that this approach will bring long-term sustainability in the sector. To implement Jal Jeevan Mission, action plans will be prepared at each level, that is village, district and state. Village action plan will be prepared by Gram Panchayat or its subcommittee with support from Implementation Support Agency, Public Health Engineering Department, Rural Water Supply Department, District Water and Sanitation Mission based on baseline survey, resource mapping and felt needs of the village community. The village action plan will be approved in the Gram Sabha when 80% of the village community present in the meeting agree to the prepared plan. Village action plan will then be submitted to District Water and Sanitation Mission for further action. For the district action plan, District Water and Sanitation Mission will be responsible for preparation and finalization. State action plan needs to be prepared with an objective of achieving overall state drinking water security in such a way as to avoid arranging water supply through tankers, drains, hand pump installation, etc. in any village. The state action plan will be prepared and finalized by State Water and Sanitation Mission with the help of Public Health Engineering Department or Rural Water Supply Department based on District Action Plan. For the successful implementation of Jal Jeevan Mission, four-tier institutional mechanism would be set up: national level, state level, district and village level. The national level is called the National Jal Jeevan Mission, which will be headed by a senior officer with a directorate. State level is called the State Water and Sanitation Mission. It will be headed by the Chief Secretary with Principal Secretary in charge of Public Health Engineering Department or Rural Water Supply Department as Mission Director. District level is called the District Water and Sanitation Mission. It will be headed by Deputy Commissioner or District Collector. The Gram Panchayat level is called the Pani Samiti or Village Water and Sanitation Committee or the User Group. The committee will be headed by Sarpanch, Up Sarpanch, Gram Panchayat member, traditional village head, senior village leader as the Gram Sabha may decide and may consist of 10 to 15 members, up to 25% elected members of Gram Panchayat, 50% women members and remaining 25% representatives of weaker sections of the village. The role of the various missions are as follows. The National Jal Jeevan Mission will provide policy guidance, financial assistance and technical support to states and coordinate with other ministries and departments for convergence. The State Water and Sanitation Mission would be responsible for coordination, convergence and policy guidance at the state level. The District Water and Sanitation Mission will ensure preparation of village action plan, finalize a district action plan, provide administrative approval of in-village water supply scheme, ensure availability of funds for resource sustainability and grey water management, approve cost estimates finalized by other committees, coordinate with Gram Panchayats, identify individuals to be trained as master trainers at state level, approve, share reports, success stories, best practices on Jal Jeevan Mission, integrated management information system, conduct campaigns, etc. The Village Water and Sanitation Committee will play a lead role in planning, implementation, management, operation and maintenance of in-village water supply infrastructure, thereby leading to FHTCs to every rural household. Functional household tap water connection in every household will be provided with 3 delivery points through kitchen, washing and bathing area and toilet. Out of the 3, only 1 tap per household will be funded under Jal Jeevan Mission. In this regard, state governments and Union Territory Administration will implement the mission based on the finalized state action plan with timelines to cover all the villages of the respective state and union territories. Each village will be assessed on existing water supply infrastructure by District Water and Sanitation Mission in consultation with Gram Panchayat or its subcommittee. Based on the same, FHTCs will be provided to every rural household by creating in-village water supply infrastructure, including source development under any of the following suggested criterias, that are retrofitting of ongoing schemes taken up under erstwhile National Rural Drinking Water Program for the last mile connectivity, retrofitting of completed rural water supply schemes to make it Jal Jeevan Mission compliant, single village scheme in villages having adequate groundwater, spring water, local or surface water source of prescribed quality, single village scheme in villages having adequate groundwater that needs treatment, multi-village scheme with water grids, regional water supply scheme, and mini solar power based piped water supply in isolated tribal hamlets. Broadly, water supply infrastructure work will fall in 2 categories. First, creation of in-village infrastructure including source development, strengthening, augmentation and grey water management. Second, infrastructure for bulk transfer of water, treatment and distribution systems. The first will be created through single village scheme, multi-village scheme or solar power based standalone schemes for scattered areas. The Gram Panchayat or its subcommittee will be responsible to plan, implement, manage, operate and maintain this. It will include protection of drinking water sources as well as treatment and reuse of grey water. In villages with water quality issues and paucity of surface water sources, especially in drought-prone and desert areas, an approach to transfer bulk water from long distance will be adopted. It will be planned, implemented, and monitored by the Public Health Engineering Department or Rural Water Supply Department or any other board or agency as decided by the State Water and Sanitation Mission or the state government. The components for transfer of water consists of headwork, intake work, tube well, pumping station, distribution network, treatment plants, elevated storage reservoir, sumps, bulk meters, substations for handling bulk water supply, etc. The total estimated cost of Jal Jeevan Mission is Rs 3.6 lakh crore with central and state share of Rs 2.08 lakh crore and Rs 1.52 lakh crore respectively. The fund sharing pattern between the center and state is 90:10 for Himalayan, northeastern states and union territories with legislature. While it is 100-0 for union territories without legislature, for the remaining states, the fund sharing pattern will be 50-50. Central financial assistance for Jal Jeevan Mission will have two sources, namely gross budgetary support and extra budgetary resources. The criteria and weightage thereof to be followed for fund allocation under Jal Jeevan Mission for both the budgetary resources will be as under. Rural population as per last census 30%, rural SC and ST population as per last census 10%, states under Desert Development Program, Drought Prone Areas Program, Hill Area Development Program and Special Category Hill Stations in terms of rural areas 30%, population as per Integrated Management Information System residing in habitations affected by chemical contaminants including heavy metals 10%, weightage for balanced individual household connections to be provided 20%. Up to 5% of such allocated funds to a state or union territory will be utilized for support activities and up to 2% of such funds to water quality monitoring and surveillance program activities. The balance will be utilized to provide FHTCs to rural households. Funds for SCs and STs will be earmarked in the state at least in proportion to their population. In order to instill the sense of ownership among the community or user groups for better implementation and long-term operation and maintenance of the scheme as well as bringing in transparency, Gram Panchayat or Pani Samiti will implement the in-village piped water supply infrastructure and related source development. Communities will contribute towards 10% of the capital cost in cash or kind or labor in all villages except for hilly and forested areas or northeastern and Himalayan states and villages having more than 50% SC or ST population, where community contribution would be 5% of the capital cost. To assist the village community for in-village water resource management and water supply related infrastructures, NGOs, voluntary organizations, women self-help groups under NRLM or SRLM etc. will be associated as partners to facilitate the communities in awareness creation, capacity building, planning and implementing the scheme. They would also mobilize the local communities, firm up their aspirations and handhold them for resource mapping as participatory approach and decentralized planning will hold the key for long-term sustainability and operation and maintenance of the system. In order to facilitate donations or contributions from various individuals, corporate or industrial houses, charitable institutions, Rashtriya Jal Jeevan Kosh is being set up under National Jal Jeevan Mission, which will serve as a receptacle for charitable contributions, donations, and CSR fund to achieve goals of Jal Jeevan Mission. Several schemes under the erstwhile National Rural Drinking Water Program have been subsumed into Jal Jeevan Mission. These schemes are given below. Rural Water Supply and Sanitation Project for Low Income States, National Water Quality Submission, Japanese Encephalitis, Swajal, Water Quality Monitoring and Surveillance is now subsumed under Jal Jeevan Mission and will receive up to 2% of Jal Jeevan Mission funds. All the erstwhile National Rural Drinking Water Program support activities are subsumed under Jal Jeevan Mission and they will receive up to 5% of Jal Jeevan Mission funds. In areas where tap water connections are not feasible, local innovations or technological solutions will be explored. Suggestive technological solutions to address challenges in the supply of drinking water are as follows. Solar energy-based standalone water supply systems for scattered, isolated, tribal, hilly areas. Community water purification plant in groundwater contaminated areas. In cold deserts, solutions may be explored to enhance and store runoff water in small tanks, traditional water harvesting structure like Zings of Ladakh. In such areas, artificial glacial reservoirs may be created by diverting the runoff to freeze and store as glacier. In hard rock areas, bore blast technique, fracture seal cementation, steam blasting, etc. may be explored. In hilly areas, adopting spring-based sources, rainwater harvesting and standalone borewell systems, if feasible, will be explored. In coastal areas, energy-efficient small desalination plants with high recovery ratio will be explored, along with construction of subsurface dikes in rivers. Use of Internet of Things and Geographic Information System software will also be required for planning and monitoring. Jal Jeevan Mission has made the provision of up to 5% of annual allocation to the states as support activities funds. All states will develop a detailed implementation strategy for taking up support activities as a part of annual action plan. For the effective implementation of Jal Jeevan Mission, following support activities would be conducted. Information education and communication among local communities, human resource development, public utility and leadership development, training and skill development, mobilization of local communities, third party inspection, change management, key resource centers, knowledge centers, documentation of best practices, success stories, publications, conducting conferences, seminars, workshops, review meetings, exposure visits on Jal Jeevan Mission, IMIS support and related IT infrastructure. For more details, visit India Water Portal, www.indiawaterportal.org. Thank you for watching.